notice how to pray. You have to learn how to pray. Heaven to fall in His place. Jesus told all His disciples how to preach. He taught us how to pray. You have to learn how to pray. Heaven to fall in His place. Hit the secret place and get lost with Him. Hit your face and give Him thanksgiving for all He's done. What is to come? A true King, God's only Son. He hit the tree, took 3 nails for me. He took my responsibility. He died for me, He died for you. Now the question is, what you gonna do? I bow down to the royalty. There's no question where I'd be if it wasn't for His grace He placed upon me. I'd probably be hanging from a tree. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Holy Spirit, I thank them all. Teach me how to pray while your voice preach. So when I hit the place, my heart leaps.
One thing that really lights a fire up underneath me is that the music is reaching souls and touching lives in a positive way. To know and to see I'm speaking life into someone or over someone's life instead of speaking death over them. You know, when you get that call or when you're in conversation with someone and they thank you because their family member or friend or even themselves has been listening to your music, and they say, now they look at life different. Now they seem to have a sense of life back in them. I know that has nothing to do with me. Christ deserves all the glory. But to know I'm being used to advance the kingdom, that's motivation. If the music you're putting out can't touch the soul when you're listening to it or have you wanting to change the world, then what's the purpose? It's the spirit that lives in me. That's the true motivation. First off, this is not a career to me. This is my ministry. I use this tool as a platform to spread the gospel. My goal is to glorify Christ in all that I do, not just in the music that the Spirit inspires me with, but in every aspect of my life, but most importantly, my calling. Being successful to me, that's a big margin, but I'd have to say success would be somewhere along the lines of every soul God has ordained for me to reach, that not only they be touched by the music and the gospel I preach, but by His grace as well. My success lies in His eyes, not this world's. So with that being said, I would never be successful in my eyes because the work of a disciple is never finished.